Okay, so chord progressions we love. When I was a kid, when I say when I was a kid, I didn't take up guitar till I was like 17. Learning the chords for Yesterday was a huge thrill for me because it was the most complicated thing up to that point that I'd actually done. Let's get my guitar in tune for a start, though, shall we? D was awfully sharp. Yeah, that B, is a bit all over the place. Anyway, it was probably the first song that I wanted to work out that wasn't just, G, C, and D. It was in G. I think it's in G. I haven't gone back to listen to the record for a while, but the idea of a F sharp minor after a G, or just, I mean, it just blew my mind. Took me ages to work it out. I didn't have any books or anything. I just had to figure it out. I knew that there was movement down. I just wasn't sure. Thought it might be F, R, G down to, but that didn't sound right. So that didn't sound right either. Just G to F sharp. As soon as I figured out that minor chord, excuse my dodgy way of playing, obviously the four chords are like this. But anyway, just that change kind of blew my mind. Then I was off and rolling, really. And I just still to this day love that. And I know it was used before back in the, as long as songwriting's been around, that idea of the tonic down to the seven chord as a minor. But it's just, when you put it like that, it's beautiful. So, yesterday, that, this. All my troubles seem so far. It gets right up there. Right. Far away. And that's about top of my range, if I'm honest. I can sometimes get their full voice up the A. Anyway, yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Just those chords. But then, I don't know, 20 years later, always been an Elvis Costello fan. An album called Mighty Like a Rose came out. When was that? About 1992. So it's probably about 10 years later. And I was very surprised. There's a beautiful song, Sweet Pear. And as the more I listened to it, the more I realized he's lifted the Yesterday opening. Sweet pear, sweet pear, those who say they love you would never dare. Obviously, to his credit, he changed it up after that, but it's the same. Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. So, sweet pear, sweet pear, those who say they love you would never dare. They're both beautiful songs. Obviously, one's a lot more famous than the other. But yeah, just that idea of using that seven minor chord. The glorious thing about Paul McCartney is he uses it as the middle eight too. So he starts the middle eight on the F sharp minor. Was she had to go? So just that. Why? It sounds like a chord change, but it's not really. There's a bunch of diatonic chords in there, and obviously he uses the odd major instead of minor to infer a chord change where there really isn't. Anyway, observations of a young man and a slightly older man and a much older man or person. So, yeah, for all you songwriters out there, think about trying to use that the seven chord of the diatonic major scale. try and incorporate that into your songwriting a little. And I'll take my own advice at some stage as well. Awesome. Bye for now.